They saw hip-hop as a black version of the punk new wave aesthetic.
There was some kind of a similarity between the punk scene and the hip-hop scene in that, you know, it was sort of the underground, you know, the underdog barking loudly.
The similarities between punk rock and hip-hop was something that I noticed early on, just seeing the way CBGB's was tagged up, like all the graffiti on the walls from different bands. I felt like there was a connection between what was going on with that, simultaneously what was going on with hip-hop, and that eventually led me to meet people from the punk scene, like Debbie Harry, Chris Stein, the group Blondie.
We met up with Freddie down at CBC, came down, and somehow or other, you know, we got to be friends.
We kind of set up what I call a cultural exchange.
We went up to the PAL at 183rd and Webster, which was like a typical spot in the Bronx where hip-hop would go down.
I don't think any group of white people had ever ventured to something like this. You know, the streets were real edgy at the time, you know what I'm saying? There was a popular dance on the scene at the time on the hip-hop scene called the Patty Duke, which is based on this TV show from way back in the days.
I could never sort of figure out. I thought it was some kind of sort of semi-robotic movement, you know? But I thought, you know, great for Patty, really.
And I was just hoping, like, oh my God, here I am. I got this group of white people with me. I hope nothing happens, you know what I mean? And I remember we was walking in, and I was kind of standing right near Debbie, and this one kid kind of looked over, and he said, "Yo, man, look, that's Patty Duke." We would kind of joke around with stuff like that, and I kind of told her, "You should make a record about me," and she just joked and laughed, you know. Chris and Debbie played the record Rapture for me at their house, but they played it, and they had these big smiles on their faces.
I think the content of the rap in Rapture was definitely an homage to the form and the people that we knew that, you know, introduced us to it and became part of our world.
I thought, oh wow, that's so cool. They just did this like as a little throwaway fun thing. I never knew it was supposed to have been on their album. So I'm in Paris about a month or so later, and the record came on the radio in the cab, and it was like, wait, what is this? Like, who's playing this record? It would play all the time back then, you know, it was just huge. The record Rapture was a pretty big hit, you know, it was number one around the world. It's not in any way a hip-hop record, but it was definitely like the first time mainstream or most of America heard an inkling of rap. You know what I'm saying? Like, this was like a little appetizer, I guess, for the explosion that was about to happen.